Hi, I am Linda, the creator of information about arthritis. If you are new to this channel, then do not forget to subscribe. Just click the button below and then click the notification bell to receive notifications of new videos when they are released. Rheumatoid arthritis is a complex and chronic autoimmune disease that affects millions of people worldwide. It is caused by inflammation of the joints and can lead to pain, swelling, and joint deformities. This condition is not only a result of wear and tear of the joints, but also, your body's immune system can get attacked. Your healthy tissues can become destroyed. These could be in the lungs, kidneys, etc. The exact cause of rheumatoid arthritis is vague, but early diagnosis can significantly improve the outcomes and therefore enhance your quality of life. The treatment including medication, physical therapy, lifestyle adjustments, and regular medical follow-ups can help manage symptoms and minimize joint damage. In this video, I will investigate into the aspects of rheumatoid arthritis, exploring its causes, symptoms, diagnosis, and much more. First, what is rheumatoid arthritis? It is an autoimmune disorder, which means the body's immune system mistakenly identifies its own healthy cells. The synovium is a thin lining surrounding the joints, which the immune system thinks is a foreign invader and starts attacking. The result of this chronic inflammation can lead to joint damage over time. While rheumatoid arthritis mainly affects your joints, it can also impact other organs such as your kidneys. Rheumatoid arthritis is one of the most common forms of arthritis and affects over 1.5 million Americans. Usually, rheumatoid arthritis appears between the ages of 30 and 60. The following are symptoms that can occur at any age from the elderly to teenagers. Even toddlers can get this horrible disease. Number 1. Joint pain and stiffness, especially first thing in the morning or after periods of inactivity. Number 2 is swelling and warmth. Inflamed joints may become swollen, tender, and warm to the touch. Number 3 is reduced range of motion. As your joints progress, they get more damaged. Therefore, you may have a decreased range of motion, making it difficult to perform regular activities, such as washing up. Fatigue and weakness. The chronic inflammation in your body can cause fatigue and a general feeling of being unwell. Fatigue can also cause low-grade fever, sickness feeling, and weight loss. Rheumatoid nodules. These are firm lumps that develop under the skin and can develop near affected joints. Spongy feeling. The last one is if you press the affected area, it will feel spongy. The areas that rheumatoid arthritis attacks are your hand and wrist and appear to be in your balls of the feet, ankles and other joints such as cervical spine, shoulders and elbows. You could also hear cracking in the jaw and joints between the very small bones in your inner ear. The exact cause of rheumatoid arthritis remains unknown, but research has found that there is a mixture of environmental, genetic and hormonal factors. Some common risk factors include genetics. A family history of rheumatoid arthritis increases the risk of developing the condition. There is a specific gene that is associated with rheumatoid arthritis, which is called HLA-DR4, that is found in 60% to 70% of people. Gender: women are more likely to develop rheumatoid arthritis than men. Smoking. Smoking is a significant environmental risk factor for rheumatoid arthritis, mainly nicotine. Prolonged nicotine is thought to increase rheumatoid factor, which is an antibody called protein. The rheumatoid factor in your blood can be a significant sign of your immune system may not be working properly. If you are overweight or obese, you have a greater risk of developing rheumatoid arthritis. This is because you are putting more weight on your weight-bearing joints, such as your hips and knees. Diagnosing requires a full evaluation. This can include a thorough medical history, physical examination, and laboratory tests, Also, you may need an MRI scan or X-ray. Blood tests can identify specific antibodies, such as rheumatoid factor, or RF, and anticyclic citrullinated peptide, or anti-CCP antibodies, which are often present in rheumatoid arthritis. A rheumatologist will examine the number and pattern of affected joints, the duration of symptoms, and other clinical indicators to confirm the diagnosis. While there is no cure for rheumatoid arthritis, there are several treatments that can help manage the symptoms to slow down the progression. Number 1 is nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, and biological agents that can reduce inflammation and pain. Number 2 is physical therapy. You should keep moving with targeted exercises and physical therapy. This can help improve joint function and reduce stiffness. Another one is quitting smoking, maintaining a healthy weight, and adopting a balanced diet can support overall well-being. But in severe cases, joint replacement surgery may be considered to alleviate pain and improve joint function. Early detection and treatment are crucial to managing the condition, preventing further joint damage. So, understanding the first signs of this disease is essential. Also, it would be better to seek medical attention sooner. The following symptoms you should look out for include persistent joint pain and stiffness, which can affect multiple joints at the same time. It tends to be more noticeable in the morning or after periods of inactivity, such as waking up or sitting for an extended period. Number 2 is that when you have rheumatoid arthritis, the joint pain is distributed throughout the body. This means that if a joint on one side of the body is affected, its counterpart on the opposite side is likely to be affected as well. For instance, if the right knee is painful and swollen, the left knee may also experience similar symptoms. Number 3 is that you may experience fatigue and general weakness and have a lack of energy. The condition's autoimmune nature can lead to complete inflammation and cause the body to feel drained, leading to overall weakness and exhaustion. 4 is joint swelling and warmth to the touch. The inflammation is caused by the body's immune system. This can mistakenly attack its own healthy joint tissues, leading to swelling and redness around the affected areas. 5 is morning stiffness that could last for more than an hour. This symptom can be particularly severe, making it challenging to perform their daily activities. Number 6 is you may have a reduced range of motion in the affected joint, making it difficult for you to perform simple tasks like bending the knees or fully extending the fingers. And lastly, in some cases, you may experience flu-like symptoms, such as a low-grade fever, loss of appetite, and a general feeling of being unwell. These symptoms may come and go, making it important to identify any patterns. If you develop any of these symptoms, seek medical advice if they persist. Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic autoimmune disorder which progresses through different stages, but not steps. These stages represent the progression of the disease over time. The following 4 stages show the increasing worsening of the condition and the possible joint damage and disability that may occur if left untreated or poorly managed. Stage 1 is early rheumatoid arthritis, initial stage. The initial stage is often challenging to diagnose, as the symptoms can be mild and general. You could experience occasional joint pain, swelling, and stiffness. These could often be mistaken for general aches and pains or other causes. In this stage, the synovial lining of the joints becomes inflamed due to the autoimmune response. The key features could be mild joint pain and stiffness, usually in multiple joints, and joint tenderness and mild swelling. Symptoms typically affect small joints, such as those in the fingers, toes, and wrists. Morning stiffness that lasts for at least 30 minutes, also fatigue and a general feeling of being unwell. Stage 2, the moderate rheumatoid arthritis, established stage. At this stage, the disease progresses to joint inflammation, becoming more obvious and extensive. The autoimmune response increases, leading to increased joint damage and deformities. At this point, you may begin to experience more significant restrictions in your daily activities. Key features can include increased joint pain and swelling, affecting larger joints such as the knees, shoulders, and hips. Also, morning stiffness lasting for over an hour and a decreased range of motion in the affected joints. Development of rheumatoid nodules, which are firm lumps under the skin that often appear near joints, and continued fatigue and weakness, which can impact daily functioning. Stage 3 is severe rheumatoid arthritis or advanced stage. In this stage, the inflammation can become persistent, causing substantial joint damage and deformities. The joint cartilage erodes, and the surrounding ligaments and tendons weaken, leading to permanent disability and loss of function. Key features can cause intense joint pain and stiffness that significantly impair movement. Severe joint deformities, including joint partial dislocation and persistent morning stiffness that may last for several hours. Fatigue, weakness, and a general feeling of exhaustion and difficulty in performing daily activities and self-care tasks. Stage 4, end-stage rheumatoid arthritis. Terminal stage. This end stage can cause severe joint destruction and irreversible damage. The condition may lead to significant disability, affecting your everyday simple tasks. In some cases, people may require surgery, such as joint replacement, to improve their quality of life. Key features are joint destruction and deformities are extensive, leading to severe functional impairment. Chronic pain and limited mobility significantly impact daily life, loss of joint function, and independence. Inflammation may spread to other organs and systems, leading to systemic complications and lastly depression and anxiety, due to chronic pain and disability. Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic and debilitating disease that requires early detection to prevent further joint damage and improve long-term outcomes. It could help if you identify the first signs, like persistent joint pain, stiffness, swelling, and fatigue. If you or someone you know is experiencing these symptoms, it is crucial to consult a healthcare professional for a complete evaluation so that a correct treatment plan can be modified. Rheumatoid arthritis progresses through 4 stages, from the initial symptoms of pain and inflammation of the joints and organs to end stage of joint destruction and irreversible damage. If your symptoms go untreated, the disease can develop into stage 4, where you could become wheelchair-bound. Therefore, an early diagnosis is crucial to slowing the progression of the disease and minimizing joint damage. Also, early detection is essential in providing you with the best possible outcomes for this chronic condition. If you experience persistent joint pain, stiffness, or any other symptoms associated with rheumatoid arthritis, seek medical assessment immediately. I am not a medical professional, and this blog is for information only. You should always consult with your doctor or medical professional if you have any worries. Please leave a comment if you have a question, and I will be glad to answer. I hope this blog has helped you.